Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today, an unboxing of a Dutch subscription box. So, if you want to know what I got in my Style Tone box this month, you just have to keep on watching. So guys, instead of an American box, a Dutch box. We have them too, you know. So we have a few boxes, and the ones that I actually found the most interesting are the Goodie box and the Style Tone box. The Style Tone box is the cheapest, and I just wanted to see if I would like that. So here is the box. I will tell you a little bit about how the subscription works, then you will, well, see what I got in the box. And at the end of the video, you hear my thoughts about them. So yeah, I got two other boxes previous, and I did film one, but it was just, I did that so weirdly that I never uploaded it. I hope this one is better, because I like watching unboxings, but I cannot get your American boxes here. So I'm always jealous. And then I was like, you know what? I want to find my own box. So I went looking and I found the Style Tone box. I wrote some stuff down. And the Style Tone box is a subscription box which is shipped, oopsie, every month. You can choose a few forms of subscription. You can do it per month. So then you pay per month, and you can also cancel it every month. You can cancel it anyway, you can put it on pause and that kind of thing. But if you do it per month, the box is €12.50. That is what I chose. So my box is, well, costs me €12.50 every month, which is about $15 or $16, I think, depending on the exchange rate. You can also choose a 3-month subscription, 6 months and 12 months. The 6 months is $37.50, and the 3 months is $37.50, and for 3 months, and yeah, the rest I just don't know. You get 5 full-sized products in the box. You get, they focus mainly on makeup, but you also get some skincare, some hair care, and all that goodness. Hair care, I don't really need. So that either goes to my son or to my sister or to a friend. And yeah, skincare just depends on what's in it. There was a skincare item in a previous box that I didn't even try. That was a cleanser, but that was a cleanser that smelled so strongly, and when I looked at the ingredients, I was like, I don't want to wash my face with that because my face is dry and will not like that. But yeah, so this is my third month that I have the subscription box, and so far I like most of the stuff that I got in the boxes. So what you get is always a leaflet with the prices in them and all that goodness. Oh yeah, before I forget, they are, the products that they have in the box are 100% cruelty free, and they pick brands from all over the world. So not just from the Netherlands or Europe, but from all over the world. Some brands I never heard of. Well, actually most brands I hadn't heard of. So yeah, it is just really fun to get stuff that you have never tried before, and yeah, get them for, well, quite cheap, to be honest. So this look is done with some products from this month's box, and the eye look isn't, because my son was, well, sometimes my son picks my colors for the day. He chose green today. He went through my collection and picked the Hasina 2. So the look that I have, I did with the Hasina 2. I did not film it, but if you want me to, I can. Just leave that down in the description box below. If you want to see how I achieved this look, I will do so. And I do want to mention that this look, the way it is now, I have never done before, and it is actually inspired by Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. I will leave her channel down below. She did 3 looks with the Destiny palette from Certify. I will leave the video down below as well. And Was it her second look or her third look? I don't know, but one of her three looks, she did this. So she did two colors in the crease and then flipped the colors on her eye. And I was just like, I really want to try that because I have never done that. And I think I did good. So yeah. Thank you, Annette, for the inspiration. And if you are watching this, I hope you like what I did. But yeah, again, let me know if you want to see how I achieved this look. For now, let's just get into the rest of the video. And I wish you a lot of fun watching me unbox a Dutch subscription box. So, the style tone. I did peek when I got it yesterday, because this box contains both makeup and skincare, and sometimes hair care, which I obviously need. But that doesn't matter. I give those away to my sister or something, or to my friend. But I did sneak peek to see, well, how much makeup I should put on beforehand. So I have the box here, and this is what it looks like when you open it, which is nice. It contains 5 full-size products. And the first thing you get is a mini magazine. Well, because this is a Dutch box, obviously it is in Dutch, but it lists what you get, the price. Can you see that? The price is here. Focus. Focus. It doesn't want to focus. Anyway, it lists the price here. It gives a little description and sometimes some tips. So yeah, let's see what we got in the box. We got from Bitin. Oh, let's go by the booklet. So the first thing is the lipstick from Ardency Inn. And this retails for 25 euros. Let me think, because I need to translate. It gives a long-lasting full coverage and feels like a soft balm. Highly pigmented, it protects the lips throughout the day. It feeds your lips, nourishes your lips. So yeah, a combination of essential oils. Make sure that this lipstick holds for a long time and retains its color. They have 3 colors that they put in the box. So you have, let me do this. Maybe this is better. So you have kind of a pinky one. That's this one, pinky red. Then you get a purpley mauvey thingy, and then you get something that's a little bit more red. The color I got is rose, circa rose. So that is this one. And this is what the packaging looks like. It's just sleek and black. And yeah, this is the thingy on top. Here is the lipstick. And let's swatch it. It is a very pretty color. Oh, nice. So here's the swatch. So that's very pretty. So I'm going to use that today. Does it close with a... It closes with a magnet, so I don't have anything like that, so that's really cool. But yeah, I don't know if it is worth 25 euros, but okay. Next thing is from Bitin. It's a tanning moisturizer. That's this one. Why does it not focus? Focus! God damn it. I am sorry, I don't know why it doesn't focus, but it doesn't focus. Anyway, it says, it's love. A daily moisturizer that makes me glow. Gradual tan, an everyday body moisturizer that gives a hint of color. It has all the ingredients on the back. And it retails for 8 euros and 99 cents. And it says how to apply. Make sure that your skin is clean and dry. Apply evenly and massage in your skin. The color is not directly visible. So this is a self-tanner, I think. And it is a body lotion, but is this a full size? It's only 30 mils. doesn't stain. I can plop it on my skin, but I already applied some of my basic skincare. So yeah, maybe I don't, it's not a good idea for me to use this now. Let me just smell it. Oh, it is sealed, so that's good. Yeah, I can kind of smell the self-tanner. But it's just white. Actually applies really nicely, really evenly. So yeah, I don't know if it's a good idea to put on my face now. I can do it tomorrow morning when I wash my face and then put it on a clean skin. Yeah. So I'm going to put that one aside. I thought it was actually just a moisturizer with a little bit of color in it. So I thought I could use that this morning, but I won't now. Okay, next up from Dr. Botanicals. It's a facial oil and it retails for a whopping $33. Euros, I'm sorry. So that is, I think, about $40. It is a facial oil. How many mils? Wow, only 15 milliliters. And it is not even completely full. Can you see that? So it stops here. And I haven't opened it. It hasn't leaked anywhere. So yeah, that is apparently what you get. Let me see. Oil from Dr. Botanicals with Moroccan oil is chunk full of minerals and vitamins. And they help with rejuvenating, protecting and renewing the skin, I had to think. It's rich in antioxidants, hydrating properties, ideal for colder days. Most important ingredients are vitamin C, vitamin A and almond oil. The vitamin C is probably the frustrating thing is I don't have ingredients here, but it is probably an ester, so a derivative of pure vitamin C, which isn't a bad thing. The vitamin A, same thing, because the only pure form of vitamin A is like Retin A, so it is a doctor's prescription, which I have. And almond oil. Almond oil is nice. It says how to use. Apply 2 drops on your hands, rub them shortly and carefully together and massage into face. My skin usually doesn't like rose. Let's see. It comes with a dropper. It is scented, which I don't know if I like. But yeah, let's try it on my hand first, because if I have an allergic reaction to this, I will notice it on my hand fairly quickly. It is really runny. It feels nice. I don't think you need a lot. It, wow, sinks in really, really fast. So that's good. And when you rub it in, it kind of loses its heavily rosy scent. So that's good. But I will let it sit on my hand for just a moment and see if my skin reacts. If my hand doesn't do anything, I will plop it on my face. What else do I have? Vita masks. Okay, so I have a hydro face mask which looks like this. So that's always good. And it is it looks like kind of a silicone-y rubbery mask. I hope you can see that. But it doesn't really look like a papery sheet mask, from the picture anyway. Vitamask is a Korean-British brand with nice and effective skincare. Again, I am translating, so if I make a boo-boo, it is my translating abilities there that are a bit not too great today. It is also affordable and it makes it accessible to everyone. They strive... Okay, this is kind of weird, but it says... At Vitamask, they strive to not testing on having products that are not tested on animals and paraben free as much as possible. It is kind of a, I have to let that sink in, but okay. Well, it says that your face will be hydrated for about 120 hours. It contains patented AMF, which is artificial moisturizing factor, which enhances the skin's ability to retain moisture. It has been clinically proven to keep the skin hydrated for up to 120 hours. Okay then. Well, anyway, it retails for 9 euros. Of course, it contains fragrance, but it is the last ingredient. So, okay then. I will try this and I will let you know. I don't know if I would pay 9 euros for a facial mask, but I will let you know. So, the last thing that I have is from Creative Cosmetics. And it is their mineral blush. It retails for a whopping 21.95 euros. Wow. How many grams of product do you get? 3 grams. Okay. It is, well, it's not really a new brand because I have seen it on Facebook. But it is a Dutch brand, so that's always nice. It's a makeup line specifically for, it says women here, but for men, women who like to wear makeup that have a sensitive skin. At Creative Cosmetics, they use nature as inspiration and work mostly with pure ingredients that come straight from the earth. In the box, you find one of 5 colors. And they are all highly pigmented, and then they say healthy, natural, and vegan. I like the vegan part. The healthy, I'm not so sure about. Okay, it contains mica, titanium dioxide, zinc oxide, iron oxide, and ultramarine blue. Okay. This says blend the blush for a soft, natural glow. For a more pigmented blush or a heavier blush, apply again. Start slow with a small quantity so you can build it up. I have the color Dora, which looks really pretty. Let me open it. And yes, that is what I thought. It is a loose blush. It looks really pretty. Really pretty color, but it is a loose blush. I use loose powders, but I have never used a loose blush. So yeah, that's going to be fun and exciting. Okay, so my hand is not doing anything weird. So let's plop a few drops on my face. I always do 3 drops because I like that. Oh wow, it sinks in really fast, even in my hand. So the way I would use this, because I really have to drag it over my skin, is, oh wow, I would spray my face with a hydrating toner or maybe just a little bit of water and then apply it, because I don't have any slip now. So I feel like I really needed to drag it across my skin. I do want a little bit underneath my eyes, so I'm just taking one a little bit. Because it sinks in so incredibly fast, you have to work fast or put it on top of a damp skin. And I usually do that with my oils applied on a damp skin, so I have more of a slip, can spread it evenly, and locks some extra moisture in my skin. But yeah, oh, it feels sticky at the same time, which is good. So you could use it as a priming oil, but I also need to apply my sunscreen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this sink in. Then I'm going to apply my sunscreen. Yeah, apply, well, actually the rest of my makeup until I'm ready to do blush and lipstick. So I'm going to go off camera and apply the rest of my makeup. I will also get some of the stuff that I got in previous boxes, because some stuff I really like, just so you know. And you will see me in just a second, ready to try a loose blush. So yeah, hold on, I'll see you soon. So most of my makeup is on. Everything I used will be down in the description box. And again, I use the Hansina 2. And yeah, let me know if you want me to film how I did the look. So yeah, let's start with, I'm sorry if I'm sniffing like that, but I'm getting a cold, I think. But let's use the lippy. Do I need a lip liner? Sure, why not? So I have a lip pencil here from BH Cosmetics, which is for me a really, really nice pinkish nude. So that's good. So let me apply that. Like so. Now let's put on the lippy. It glides on really, really smoothly. I like the color a lot, actually. It feels nice. And we will see if my lips like all the good stuff they have put in that. Now we have the blush. So I have a favorite blush brush. I just don't know if that will work with loose blush. I don't know, but I have this one. This one is from BH Cosmetics, but it is the shape that I like. So yeah, it has a sifter and a plasticky on it that I'm going to get off now. And I think I'm just going to do the same thing as I do with my powder, and let's just get a little bit in the cap. Like so. It's a very pretty color though. And just, I don't know, dip the side of my brush in, because that is what I do. I'm tapping it off. And let me just, I don't know, apply it like I would my eyeshadow. If I do loose powder, I also dab it on first. So now let me get a little bit on the tip and just... It's very pretty. Ooh, it has a nice sheen. And I don't feel like it is wanting to take my foundation off. Granted, I have a combination of the Estee Lauder Superwear and my LA Girl Pro HD Coverage, the illuminating one. I really like that combination, so I mix it about 50-50, I think, or maybe a little bit more of the double wear. And that really seems to work. Wow, this is gorgeous. Oh, it has such a pretty sheen. Oh, I like that. So I'm not putting anything more on my cap, but I am again dabbing in the side like this. Then I tap it off and then I place that on my cheek. I dab it on, and I also, I don't know if I said that already, also do that with loose powder. When I'm setting my foundation, I always place it first and then buff. Like I do with my eyeshadow. Now, a little bit on the tip. I think that this side is more blushed than this side. I have a little bit left on my cap, so let's just add. And maybe this is the wrong brush, but... really, really pretty blush. And if you feel that you have used too much, just take your sponge, or I don't know what you used to apply your foundation with. I like that blush. I think it's really pretty. I also like the lippy. I think that the color is very nice. And to be fair, it is not as difficult or as messy as I thought this would be. So that is good. I said in the beginning or previous part that I got more stuff in my box, previous boxes, and that is correct. Let me grab a few products. So what I also had in previous boxes was this cream eyeshadow from Nabla in the color Caffeine, and it's a very pretty color, very, very pretty. I will put it out here because I need to use it more. And this one from Golden Rose, which is also pretty. I just don't use single eyeshadows. Can I get it to open? That would be nice. Oh yeah, here. So it's a very pretty dark blue with a golden fleck in it. It's very pretty, but I just don't grab loose shades, but I will plop them there so that I can see them and use them more. What I also got was, excuse the cap because I use this for my lash glue, is a loose powder from the brand Effect. And it's just a fixing powder, fix and matte, but it does have a scent. But you know, it is a fixing powder. It doesn't dry out, so that is good. I don't know if it leaves a white cast with flash photography because I don't do that. But yeah, so it is a loose powder, you know? I don't know what to say about it. And then I got a mascara from the brand Mana Kadar, the Goddess Flutter Mascara in Jet Black. This mascara was quite expensive. I will list the prices of all the stuff down in my description box. This is the wand. The mascara is okay, but the wand is just so huge, you know? My eyes aren't that big, but look. So what I can do is use the thicker part, the bulbous part for underneath my eyes. I can do that. I don't know if it's really volumizing, to be honest. I think my Lash Princess is more volumizing. And this was a really expensive mascara. Not that I paid for it, because it came in a box, but still. So yeah, is this really good? Yeah, it's a black mascara. I do have to say, for the price that I saw listed in my leaflet, I thought, well, this should really blow me away, and it didn't. Again, I will link the site down below. I will link the price down below as well, the retail price. So yeah, the Goddess Mascara by Mana Kadar is, yeah, no, it's okay. It's a black mascara, it's okay. Same with the eyeshadows. I did use them, the one from Nabla and the one from Golden Rose. And I don't use cream eyeshadows. I just don't, but it is a very, very pretty color. They also had a pinky one in the boxes, and unfortunately I got a brown. So yeah, that is that. What I really, really like of my boxes is this one. This is my lip and blush stick by the brand Luxe, and it is spelled like, do you? I don't think you can see. Why are you not focusing? Come on. Ah, there it is. So that is how you spell it. I had never heard of the brand, but it is a lip and blush stick. I did use it as a blush. It's very pretty, but I don't think it's practical. But this is the color. And as a lippy, it is friggin' fantastic. Again, I will list the price down below. So I had the powder, which is, yeah, it's a powder. The mascara, which is, yeah, it makes my lashes black. This one I freaking love. Is it now not focusing on my face? What the age? There I am. I don't know. So yeah, today I got the oil. The oil is nice. It doesn't irritate my skin, so that is good. I cannot really say anything more. As long as it doesn't irritate my skin, I'm happy, you know. And for any skincare product to, well, get any results, you have to use it for at least a month, preferably longer. But yeah, as long as it doesn't irritate my skin, I'm happy. So that is good. The lippy is really, really pretty. It's a lipstick. It will transfer. I can feel that. So yeah, it transfers. I don't know how long it will stay. It doesn't feel that it will dry out my lips. So yeah, that is good. I like the packaging, and I think I saw this brand somewhere before, but I'm not sure where. I like the fact that it is a high-end packaging that I can feel. It's nice and sturdy. It feels like metal, but I don't know if it is. So yeah, but would I pay that kind of money for that lippy? Let me see what it was again. It retails for 25 euros. I don't know. I don't know. I don't think so. But then again, I don't know. So yeah, do I think that this month's box is worth the money? Yeah, I think I do. You know, even though I wouldn't pay 25 euros for this, granted it is a luxury packaging, but I think actually that the inside is more important than the packaging. It feels really nice. I would pay around 10 euros for it, but you know, I don't know if I would pay 25. So let's plop it at 10. So that's 10. The box costs 12.50. So yeah, I think it's worth its money. I also really like this blush, so I am definitely going to wear it more often. I even forgot to wear to put on highlighter, but I think the color is really pretty. I think the finish is really nice. And to be honest, I would actually like to try a mineral foundation. If you have experience with that, please let me know down in the description box. What else did I get? The oil I got. It's nice. I would never, for the life of me, pay 33 euros for an oil of 15 milliliters. Because my all-time favorite oil is the board seed oil from The Ordinary. 30 mils for under 5 euros. So, yeah. I think it's nice. I would not have paid that price for it, but I think it's nice. So yeah, overall, I think this month's box is really worth its money. I will try out the sheet mask as well. And to be honest, I don't really know if I will try this one. That's the tan cream. Maybe I will. I'm not sure yet. So yeah, that was this month's box. And that was one of the Dutch boxes that we can get here, the Style Tone box. Yeah, I want to do this again next month and then give you an update on the products that I got in this month's box. And if I like them still and how the others that I couldn't try now performed. So this was it for me. Again, let me know down in the description box if you want me to film this look, because I can. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know if you know any of these brands that I got in my box. All the websites of the products that I mentioned are listed down below. If I can find the prices, I will list them down as well. And my makeup will be down in the description box. And that is it for today's video. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't hit the subscribe button, go do so. You know you want to. Yes. It will be our little secret. I won't tell. Anyway, while you're clicking buttons, don't forget to click the bell. I don't really know if it is working correctly again, but then you know that you have done everything that you can possibly do to get notified of my next upload, which will be very, very soon. For now, I'm signing off. I wish you all a great, great day, and I hope to see you on my next one. Bye, guys.